Classic Hawk. Weekly replays of some of the greatest episodes in 108.9 The Hawk history. Maybe you've heard it before, or maybe you've never heard it at all. Relive some of the greatest moments of 108.9 The Hawk now. Get out those lunch sacks and toss them in the river. It's time for a different kind of lunch.
Where's your lunch?
You're wearing it.
You're nauseating.
108.9 The Hawk's All Request Liquid Lunchtime.
Well, what's there to eat?
Get your calls in now. Requests your favorites. And no matter what, the DJ has to play it.
You can't handle the truth.
The 108.9 The Hawk All Request Liquid Lunchtime.
Yes! Yes!
I'll have what she's having.
On 108.9 The Hawk. That's right. It is the 108.9 The Hawk All Request Liquid Lunchtime. 1 hour of nothing but your requests. So get ready for Valverde surrounding areas. This is your shot. I'm Jason Gore alongside my good partner in rock,
Geoff the Angry Man Garlock. How you doing today, Jason?
I'm doing good. I'm doing better now, man. This is going to be a fun one. I can already feel it.
It feels like there's a different vibe. There's a healthier vibe. There's a fun vibe when the people are calling in, letting us know what classic songs from classic rock they want to be hearing.
Yeah.
All hour long.
So give us a call, 422-444-3428-69. It's a long number.
Please do. It is a very long number. Almost worried we even lost a couple numbers in there.
But I probably did. I probably stepped over a couple. But like I said, it is all requests, and the rules are, no matter your request, as long as it rocks, we have to play it. So
these are the rules. We follow the rules.
There's the
rules. One thing you know about us. There's two things you know about us. One, we love classic rock. And two, we step right in line with rules.
We do not. I mean, you would think rock and roll bad boys would be like, no time for rules, but I think there's something rock about following rules.
Oh yeah, I think being super conservative about rules,
yeah,
is the most rock. I think following rules is the new rock and roll.
Hell yeah, man. Hey, we're also gonna be giving out tickets to see Grand Punk Railroad. They're playing at the Verde Dome this weekend. Now that is, of course, Grand Funk Railroad playing all of your classic punk songs in a Grand Funk Railroad style. That's how they get Grand Punk Railroad.
Exactly. It is not Grand Funk Railroad played in a classic punk style. So if you bought tickets for that,
yes,
which is Punk Funk Railroad,
yes,
that is a different date at the Valverde Dome.
And that's the guys from NOFX, correct?
Oh, yes. Yeah. They take a break from NOFX and then take a break from Me First in the Gimme Gimmies.
Right.
And they go straight into Punk Funk Railroad. And Punk I got to say, it's amazing that both of those shows have sold out the Verde Dome. I mean, that is a large venue.
I think, Geoff, when you get down to it, there is a certain taste in the Valverde Valley for both classic punk songs played in the Grand Funk Railroad style, and also Grand Funk songs played by punk bands.
Ugh, I mean, exactly. I mean, I'm sure there are some days that the Valverde patronage, the people of Valverde, really just wish that there were two styles of music. All music sounds like Grand Funk Railroad.
Yes.
Or a world where everything sounds like pop punk.
Yeah, oh yeah, oh
like,
definitely.
And no matter if there was a variation in the original song that was covered, that in the end, it just sounds exactly like it came out on Fat Records or Epitaph.
Yeah.
And that's the thing with us. We know about these indie labels as well. We are purveyors of music here.
We definitely are. And hey, Geoff, we'll talk more about Grand Punk Railroad coming up, but we got to get right into it. It is the 108.9 The Hawk All Request Liquid Lunchtime. Liquid Lunchtime, you're on the air.
Hey, yeah, this is Cody.
Cody, where are you calling from, Cody?
I'm calling from my car. My dad says you suck.
Okay.
Did you hear me?
Did you hear me?
My dad.
Yeah,
my dad says
we heard you. We suck.
Yeah. No, it was loud and clear, Cody.
Oh, good. Good. I wasn't sure because I'm in my car. I'm just cruising.
Yeah. Are you listening to 108.9 The Hawk in the car?
No. Fuck. No. You guys suck. I'm listening to 98.6 The Squirt.
Oh,
squish,
Jesus.
Squish,
squish. Squish,
squish. Squish.
Okay, is your dad in the car, or is this just something he brought up at maybe like dinner table or something?
Yeah. My dad brought this up at Christmas. He said that you guys are the worst radio station he's ever listened to. Uh-huh. And everything my dad says is awesome. So I believed him.
How old are you, Cody?
I'm 17.
You're 17.
I'm 17.
There's going to come a time in your life, Cody, when you start to think for yourself and you don't have to think what your father thinks.
I truly don't think that's going to happen. And I don't think you guys give good advice because you honestly kind of suck.
Well, wow. Kind of hurtful.
Yeah.
No, thank you for agreeing that this is hurtful, Cody. That definitely does.
Yeah, I know. That's my intent. Yeah. My intent is pain.
Okay, your intent is pain. Yeah. Okay,
Well, while I have you, though, can I request a song?
I mean,
it is liquid lunch.
It is liquid lunch time. Yes! So,
Ragdoll by Aerosmith.
And by law, we have to play it.
Rules are rules.
Rules are rules.
We talked about this. Rock and roll is rules. All right.
Cody, thanks for the call.
Thanks. You suck.
Okay.
Right at the end.
Okay. Ragdoll. See, I'll request liquid lunchtime. Off to a weird start.
Not very fun, gotta say. All right.
Okay. Get your calls in right now. Aerosmith, Ragdoll on the Hawk.
Hello, Farmer Dan, down at Shetland Creameries. And frankly, yeah. I don't know what you want from me anymore. God damn it, you keep coming out here. And I keep telling you, the cows are fucking gone. At one moment, I'm hell-bent on revenge. The next moment, I'm just terribly, terribly sad. People came to Shetland Creameries because they knew they would get a good deal on some very, very good milk from cattle that were treated with love. Cattle, if you're listening, what did I do? Was it something that Farmer Dan said that made you leave? We never even had a single argument at all. I thought we were family, but I guess I was wrong. Shetland Creameries. What else can I say?
There are 20 radio stations in Valverde, and we're at the very bottom of that list. 108.9, The Hawk. Hey, I mean, we may have just been razzed on air,
but then we got ragged.
We got ragged. If we get razzed and then we get ragged, I'm gonna be okay with this.
Yeah, I mean, it's not the start that we thought it would be. I think maybe, you know, she's got some issues with her father, sounds like. But that scatting helped out my mood. I'm glad it turned did. Around there. Gotta say, still think it was harsh.
I still think it was very harsh, but then hearing that, made me feel so much better.
All right. I mean, my spirits have been buoyed. I have faith in classic rock and Valverde again. But hey, because this is liquid lunch, and we take your requests.
Yes,
and that was a great request. That's why we do this. Because
it is why we do this. It is 108.9 The Hawks. I'll request liquid lunchtime. Phone lines are wide open, meaning literally nobody is calling.
20 to 40 lines open. And so, you know, depending on the telemarketers, we keep also getting it. We are getting those calls. A lot of calls telling us our warranty is up on our car. We are a radio station, but send in those calls.
We also do have a station vehicle, so it is good to know when the warranty is up on that vehicle.
It is. I'm not convinced this is the one they're talking about, because I certainly don't have my name on, and they keep talking to me specifically on these calls.
Specifically to you.
But phone lines are open. Pour us a big cup of requests, because we'll drink it down.
Hey, before we get into another request, Geoff, let's talk a little real news. Neil Young released a Lost Summer Songs album on his Neil Young Archives over the weekend. That's pretty exciting.
Very exciting. More Young. I wonder if it sounds, have you heard any yet?
I have heard some of it. It came from 1987. It was called Summer Songs. And it's basically a lot of songs, Geoff, you've already heard before. So you've got like Wrecking Ball on there. You've got One of These Days from Harvest Moon. American Dream without Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young. So that already makes it a better version?
Yes, it does. You know, when you're not getting new music, there's nothing better than getting some demos.
Oh, God.
Then you really see what the heart and soul of the song was. Right?
Give me the demos. Just give me all of them.
Yeah. I mean, if I could get a record from my favorite bands called Haven't Figured It Out Yet, and it's just where all the parts where they're like, we're going to change this section a little bit later, because then you get to see the heart. It's like look, you know my feelings on the Beatles.
Oh, here we go.
Here we go. Not my favorite band, but I have to say that Peter Jackson documentary made me say I need to see the roots of every single song that I like now.
What band, Geoff? If you had to see the roots in a way that we saw the roots in Peter Jackson's Get Back, what band would you like to see those roots?
You know what? My gut was to go the Bee Gees just to be difficult.
Oh.
But we know the roots of that.
We know the roots of that.
That's Barry writing a billion songs. He just shits them out, and then for some reason, Robin is in the corner drawing penises on everything.
Yeah.
And that's a fact. That's in his autobiography.
And Morris is just like, I'm leaving them two alone until I get some songs to sing.
Exactly. He's doing drugs in the corner.
Yeah.
You know, Steely Dan, we know what goes on with Steely Dan.
Oh, God, yeah.
Sha-na-na?
That'd be a deep dive.
I wouldn't mind it. Really get the roots of how they got to those roots of rock and roll in their songs.
I would personally like, a Sammy Hagar one.
Oh.
Like, was there a different speed at first? Like, I can't drive 55, but I also can't drive 45.
Did you think that there was a version? Maybe there was a demo version where he just is listing off all of the speeds he can't drive.
What if there's a version where he's just driving through a small town and it's, I can't drive 25!
I can't drive 15 in construction!
See, that's what I want to hear. Peter, we know you listen to The Hog, Peter Jackson.
Of course.
Get on this.
I want a 20-hour documentary on all of my favorite bands, seeing the roots, so we can be like, I can't believe he just came up with that song, I Can't Drive 55, like that.
I would like to see one for the Georgia Satellites.
Oh, forget about it.
Like, especially about the video for, where they're all in the back of that truck. It's like, I got a little change in my pocket going jingle-ling-a-ling. Maybe there was something else in his pocket.
I mean, probably a gum wrapper.
I've got a gum wrapper in my pocket going crinkle, crinkle, crinkle.
I got a Bazooka Joe comic in my pocket going ha-ha. I mean, the things are endless, and we'll never know until Peter Jackson gets on it.
Yeah. Get on it, Peter Jackson. Come on.
Get on it, Peter Jackson. If I'm not going to be happy until there's a 40-hour Fabulous T-Birds documentary.
Oh, please. Please, Peter Jackson. I dare you. I fucking dare you.
We're putting the gauntlet down.
Gauntlet.
We dare you.
Down, Jackson. Hey, it is the 108.9 The Hawk All Request Liquid Lunchtime. And let's get back to it. Liquid Lunchtime, you're on the air.
Hey, what's up? My name's Trent. And I have to be kind of quiet because I'm at work right now.
Trent.
I'm in this conference room right now, and I just want to tell you guys fucking suck real hard, okay? I've been listening to the Squirt all morning long, and they've been playing all the hits. I'm talking all the hits from the 70s and beyond, and it's incredible. And you guys your signal sucks. Do you guys have 5G? Like, what's going on with that?
Well, first off, Trent, we're a radio station, so we wouldn't have 5G. Does the Squirt have 5G?
I mean, yeah, they do. They have 5G. Oh, they got 4G. They got LTE. They got AT&T. They're rocking and rolling, man.
My gut is they're lying to you. It's kind of like when a storage unit puts like I in front of it, saying that they're Apple related. But Trent, this is the request line. If you want to hear the hits, we'll give you the hits. Tell us what hits you want to play.
First off, you guys play way too much Aerosmith, all right?
Okay.
We get it, okay? We get it. Aerosmith had some hits. You know what I'm saying? But, like, We're not in Massachusetts. I don't need to hear Aerosmith every other song. You know what I'm saying?
That's a fair point. That is
it is a fair point, but also, Trent, do you want to hear more hits or more deep cuts? I'm getting confused on your anger.
I want deep cuts of the hits. Like, I want, okay, like, songs that cracked the top 10 but immediately fell out. You know what I'm saying?
I suppose.
Yeah.
We could go into the Wikipedia, I guess, and help you out. I mean...
I want it like number 11 or 12 on their greatest hits. You know what I'm saying? Like not Tom Sawyer, like, you know, Huckleberry Finn from Rush. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Like the follow-up,
so like the
to
trees
Tom
or something.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
That's what
so
I'm
you
about.
You want maybe so we so okay, we'll start maybe we'll try to find the songs that are on the greatest hits that you always think like, "Oh, maybe they need to fill in the gap there."
What about some of the new songs that artists record for those greatest hits albums? Would you be happy with those?
I'd be happy with those, but And I got to go because it looks like someone else rented out this conference room at the same time as me. But what I want to say is stop playing Aerosmith.
Okay.
And then also, you guys taking requests right now?
It's Liquid Lunch.
It
please.
Is Liquid Lunch time, so.
Yeah. Can you play Ragdoll by Aerosmith?
Trent. Okay. Confusing.
Literally what you just told us not to do.
Well, you know, like, you can listen to me or you can, like, listen to the squirt. That's all I'm saying. All right. I got to go. I got to make some trades on the stock market. Okay, bye.
All right.
God, didn't... Should have known he was a stock douche.
Yeah, I mean, that should have maybe...
Trent, right away, I was thinking.
Right away. He's probably Trent down there at the Valverde Stock Exchange.
Yeah.
So that puts
trading
him where he
bellies.
Is.
Like the number one pork belly stock trading in America. All right. Well, he doesn't. I guess we're going to Wikipedia to find some songs. Ragdoll.
Ragdoll.
Are you tired of lawsuits incurred only because you're a grown-up fan of hair metal?
Are you tired of getting penalized for things that people at one point would have said, boys will be boys, but now say a criminal?
Have you had enough? Hi, I'm Frank Enough Di Natale, former roadie of Enough's Enough and current lawyer.
And hi, I'm Stan's Enough, brother of bassist Chip's Enough from Enough's Enough and current lawyer. Do you keep getting in trouble for things that were badass when you were rocking on the Sunset Strip?
But now are apparently criminal? It's not your fault the world is lame, but we got your back.
And we are here to be on your side. In all types of cases, like
criminal mischief,
alimony payments,
child support disputes,
drunken vandalizing,
car crashes,
car manslaughter,
anything involving you and a car and clearly being drunk,
not to mention
attempted murder outside of a Faster Pussycat Rat Show at Shooter's Bar and Buffet
in the parking lot
of the Valverde Memorial Strip Mall on Hog Street. Look, those party days may be over, but you shouldn't be held accountable for everybody else forgetting how to rage.
Enough's enough, lawyers.
For when you've had enough. Z-enough.
108.9, The Hawk.
You know, he really went out of his way to shit on us. Like,
that's two calls in a row, though. Like, statistically.
Doesn't seem right. Like, why bother calling us in? I mean, I guess he had more of a valid, maybe, complaint, but still seemed confusing, but he had to go to the inner sanctums of his office just to do that. I mean, again... I don't know that the ragging helped at the end. The
ragging didn't help. It did cheer my mood a little bit more. But I will say that, like, you know, on 108.9 The Hawk, you do get the deep cuts. We play Huckleberry Finn by Rush. What he brought up all the time.
I know. One of the demos of Tom Sawyer from the. I wish I knew what Rush sounded like before they added more drums.
Yeah.
But I mean, we play Iron Man and Paranoid a lot by Sabbath. I'll give them that. But we got like, that's Ron's.
Yeah.
deal. And if we could, we'll play War Pigs now and then. It happens.
Yeah. We play Heartbreaker, Livin' Lovin' Maid, two for all the time. But man, if you want Achilles' Last Stand, we'll play it.
We'll play it when you and me need to take a shit. We'll play it. But it's just, our hands are tied, I guess is what I'm saying. We've got playlists, we have commercials that we have to get to, and it's just, there's a format, and I don't know what the squirt is doing if they're playing Bytor the Snow Dog over there. Like, how are they playing these deep cuts? If they're pulling out Working Man by Rush, and we're over here playing Spirit of Radio over and over again, talk to Rut, but how are they surviving and beating us?
All I have to say is this. I woke up this morning so jazzed to do the 108.9 The Hawk All Request Liquid Lunchtime. And I gotta say, I'm kind of feeling bummed out now.
That's the thing. I am with you, brother. I was feeling a little low. I was feeling a little low about life.
Yeah.
Feeling a little low about the state of the world, where my place is in it. Getting older.
When you say world, you just mean classic rock, though, right?
Yeah, no. Is there anything else going on? No, just in the world of classic rock.
Just wanted to clarify.
There's not enough new classic rock coming out.
Good.
But, yes, no, but I'm just feeling a bit down. But then I thought, well, at least me and Jason will get our spirits buoyed by the fine people of Val Verde. And to show us that we're not wasting our lives.
You want to know something else that I found out, too, Geoff?
What?
Squirt's playing new rock.
Excuse me?
Squirt's playing new rock.
Excuse me?
Squirt's playing new rock.
Excuse me, baking powder. Yeah. What did you just say?
They're playing new rock.
You're saying like Pearl Jam.
No, man, Geoff, that's classic rock now.
That's Red Hot Chili Peppers. Rock.
No, it counts as our favorites.
What?
Yes, no, like Breaking the Girl, we could play that right now by the Red Hot Chili Peppers.
That just came out like 2 years ago,
no,
right?
No, dude, that was like 20 plus years ago.
Oh, I'm going to throw up. Okay.
But they're playing new rock.
Well, that's a complete break of format.
But they're defeating us. Should we be playing new rock?
I don't even know where to start.
Where do I begin?
I've heard of something called Pitchfork. Is that something we could look at?
Oh, man, they're not going to... I'm not going to look at any sites. Let's look.
Is it a website?
I'm putting in Pitchfork.
Okay.
Pitchfork.
I thought I heard my niece talk about some Shotgun Kelly guy or something. We could play her, right? Or maybe Waxam Abachi? Is that a band?
I don't know if either of those are real.
They don't sound real, but also... Good.
I think I just found our salvation, man.
What we got?
Wolfgang Van Halen has a record.
Hello.
Man,
you just found me the prescription. Man, are you kidding me?
Let's see. I hope it sounds exactly like Van Halen.
My ears are ready for Pasadena's finest.
Oh.
Yeah, that doesn't sound anything like Van Halen.
No, it doesn't. I gotta say. That was a big booming bass. That was no Michael Anthony.
Yeah, that sounded too good for Michael Anthony.
It really was. I almost heard a second note in there. And that's not the Anthony way of playing bass.
I mean, if you're gonna be Eddie Van Halen's kid,
you gotta be better.
You can at least do some double taps.
At the very least. You start off a song with double taps in massive synth that no one else could play but yourself.
And if you played with Van Halen, you could at least start with a
exactly. I mean, that sounded like garbage to my ears.
Come on.
That is not, I couldn't,
new
are
rock.
They playing that new rock?
New Get rock. Out of here. Squirts, that's all over the squirt. That's the latest single from Mammoth WVH, Don't Back Down, which honestly, I mean, off the air, I probably would love the hell out of that.
Sure, off the air, but this is a classic rock station, Jason. Don't start that. We got rules. Rock and roll is rules. We discussed this at the beginning. You follow the rules, and we follow the rules of classic rock, and that means no new rock. Not know what the kids are listening to. And the kids are definitely listening to Wolfgang's record, but we're not going to do that. That's not for us. Unless someone requests it.
Unless somebody requests it.
Maybe someone will request it. Just saying. It's in their hands.
It is in their hands. Let's get back into this. It is the 108.9 The Hawk All Request Liquid Lunchtime. Liquid Lunchtime, you're on the air.
Hey, yeah, thanks for having me on the air. I just got a quick question. What makes you think you know what rock and roll is all about?
Oh,
you heard me. What makes you think you know what rock and roll is all about? Were you there?
Yeah.
Were you there when it all went down?
I mean, I was there for a good chunk of it.
When it went to shit, you were there? Were you on the barricade or were you in a bunker, man? That's my question.
Well, when you're talking about rock and roll, what are you referring to? And
do you even know how the magic was made?
You really just barreled into this. Did you not tell us who you are?
Phonies like you. My name is Geoff Parsley, and I'm calling because phonies like you are the reason why the world forgets how the magic was made when it all went down.
Well, Geoff,
all right?
Geoff Parsley, were you there when the magic was made?
Good question.
Oh, don't turn it around and ask me if I was there when the magic. Let me tell you a story, because you guys are a disgrace to Val Verde. My father was the owner of Eastman's Auto Shop, you know, on Wiswall Ave for 30 years until the day this show came on the air. And he turned to me and he says he didn't have it in his heart to fix cars anymore because he knew that the last spark of rock and roll had finally got out. So I ask you once again, what makes you think you know what rock and roll is all about? Have you no sense of decency, sir? After all this time, have you no sense of decency?
That's my question. That's why Old Man Parsley stopped doing cars?
That's why Old Man Parsley stopped doing cars.
I heard Geoff, it was alcohol.
Parsley did.
Yeah, no, I thought he was a massive alcoholic, and that's why Mike and the Mechanic could slide into Valverde and take over in the automotive trade.
Listen, that guy doesn't know cars, and you guys don't know how the magic is made, all right? You know who knows how the magic's made? You know who knows how the magic's made?
Your father?
98.6 The Squirt, son, man. That's where my loyalty lies. 98.6 The Squirt knows that rock wasn't a feeling, man. It was a sensation, okay? And 98.6 The Squirt knows that it wasn't about the money, man. It was about the money, dude. Come on.
But we're barely making any money, Geoff.
I'm making no money. He doesn't get
a paycheck.
Good. Keep it that way. Money's for closers, all right? What about that? I am so blown away.
Geoff Parsley. Outside of Angry Man Geoff here, I need to clear that up. Parsley.
Thank you.
What could we do? I want to fix this for you, and I want to fix this for the memory of your father, because we know, you know, he died in that bus crash.
I thought he was an alcoholic.
I thought it was alcohol, but apparently,
on his wounds, but
like, your dad was a good guy. What can we do better, man?
You want to know? You really want to know?
Yeah, I'm asking, Parsley.
Can you guys play Ragdoll by Aerosmith?
God damn it.
Son of a bitch. Right.
Jesus. It's not, I don't even really care about the song, but my,
But what?
But my ex old lady loves the Frankie Valli version, and I want her to be disappointed whenever she thinks it's about to come on the radio.
Didn't even turn around to be sweet.
God, oh my god.
All right. We'll play it because it's Liquid Lunchtime.
Here it is.
All right. Thanks. I'm feel better. I got a lot going on in my life. I don't mean to take it out on you guys.
I'm going to bring the song down for that. That was very nice of you to say.
Yeah.
That's the first kindness we've had all Liquid Lunchtime.
It's just to live in a post-rock world is just not, you know.
Yeah.
It's not the future you want for yourself for your children.
I mean, we were just talking about that. You know,
why I'm surprised you listen to the Squirt, because they're playing new music.
They play much new rock.
I thought you were going to be one of those guys who said classic rock only started and ended with the Trogs, but I guess not.
The thing the Squirt knows is that rock isn't a feeling; it's a sensation. Okay.
Oh.
So that's why I listen.
Still a differentiation I'm not feeling, clear on. But.
You don't know the difference between a feeling and a sensation? Man, I pity you,
apparently not, according to you, Sam, but I don't want to get angry. You said something nice to us. The angry man doesn't want to get angry.
I pity you, man. A life without a sensation instead of a feeling is not a life worth living, man. I pity you. I'm so sorry. I'm really sorry for you, man.
I appreciate that. I could use a SARS. Could we use that on a shirt, though? I'm just wondering. That's actually a good phrase you got there. Might have to have you write that down.
What? I pity you, man?
Oh, the first one. A life lived without a feeling, a sense. I mean, well, I think we'd get sued by
feeling or sensation. That one.
You get sued. You get sued by me, man. You get sued by me. If you add intellectual property theft to your litany of sins, man, then you got a fucking toasty reckoning waiting for you.
Now I feel like we're back to him being angry.
Yeah, and I will say,
maybe we should go to Ragdoll. I don't know.
Okay, let's do Ragdoll.
This guy.
It's Ragdoll on 108.9 The Hawk.
God damn it.
Hello, everyone. It's Mike Rutherford from Mike and the Mechanics, 1244 Hawk Street in Valverde. We're hearing a lot of rumblings that we are the party responsible for the unfortunate demise of Eastman's Auto, and this could not be further from the truth. This garage was on sale fair and square. There was no tomfoolery, and you'll get no tomfoolery when we're working on your automobile. In fact, we won't even smile when you pull your automobile into the all I need is an oil change fast lane. We'll get it done. If any members of the Parsley family would like to come down, the first oil change is on Mike Rutherford. I've got Genesis tour money coming in now. I can swing it. Mike and the Mechanics, say it loud, say it clear. Say, please fix my automobile. Mike and the Mechanics, 1244 Hog Street.
Oh man, I love this station. It's the best.
The Hawk.
I'm pulling it down. It doesn't even make me feel good anymore.
I know. I think I was faking it that time. I wasn't feeling it at all. Can you know? I'm just gonna say, I'm sorry for Parsley's loss, but I really. If he wants to blame anyone, he can blame Mike Rutherford for coming in and taking away his father's business. But also, more importantly, no, I'm saying if he wanted to have a scapegoat, I would never blame him. But he should blame the alcoholism. I think
blame
we know
dad.
His father. His father had a lot of issues, and it was the town secret we all knew.
And here's the thing, you know, that when you guys were talking a little bit about litigation, I was about to stop you and be like, Geoff, you might want to back off because we know that his family has the lawyers because, of course, the bus crashed into the bus depot, killing 45 people.
Yeah. That's why we have such issues with Stan. Stan's the lawyer. And I you know, it's like Stan, I got a real love-hate relationship with him. He's a real son of a bitch.
Oh, what a piece of shit, Stan. Stan, if you're listening, fuck you.
Yeah, Stan, go to fucking hell. You're fucking ruining our fucking liquid lunch here. But hey. Okay.
I mean, we got.
I just reminded myself of what we're doing here.
Jesus Christ.
Trying to have a fun time with the people of Valverde, and I thought we would.
We got all of these special sweepers cut. I haven't used a single one. It's like, I haven't felt like it. It's like,
glug,
my
glug.
My heart isn't in it.
Liquid lunchtime.
Glug, glug. That's fun.
That's real fun. I like that.
And then I've got
bottoms up. Open your mouth. Drink it down. Glug glug.
And
that would have felt great after Steely Dan's Peg. But how could they have ruined Ragdoll for me now too? I don't even want to hear scatting in a song anymore. It feels like and it's just disappointing.
It's really disappointing. Like I said, I woke up this morning wanting to do. I mean, I slept in the studio.
I almost tripped over you when I came in. Trying to sleep in the studio last night myself. It's all right. You got the good couch.
I
slept in the tub that we've got.
It's liquid lunch time on
liquid lunch. Phone lines are wide open.
Phone lines are completely wide open.
Yeah.
Apparently the squirt is also doing a liquid lunch. I just found that out. But hey, let's keep ours going. Let's make ours more fun. We did get a call, just pop on. It's 108.9, The Hawks, all request liquid lunchtime. You're on the air. Who do we got?
Hey, long time listener, first time caller.
Oh,
but
great. Thank you.
I just had one quick question.
Yeah.
Why do y'all suck so bad?
Come on.
And then number two, how come y'all don't play any lady music?
Okay, now...
Let's
break this down.
It's just Tom Petty this, Led Zeppelin that, Steely Dan this, Van Halen that, Thin Lizzy
We play Barracuda
this.
All the time. Barracuda is one. Ron keeps forcing us to play Barracuda. Not forcing us.
No, we want to play it because Heart's great.
We want to.
That's one song.
We've got Crazy on You. Crazy on You by Heart.
I haven't heard a single Sheryl Crow song since I started listening this morning.
Sheryl Crow is not classic rock.
That is not classic rock. Go to the store for that.
Are you kidding me?
No.
She's the hardest rocker in the lady world that there is.
In the lady world, maybe.
We are not disputing how hard she would rock at a Lilith Fair, but it's just by the rules of classic rock, and we have established rules are important for rock. She just does not fit into the exact description of classic rock. We would love to play her.
Our
hands are tied.
She also once dated Eric Clapton, so that disqualifies her.
Does disqualify. We do have a kind of strict no Clapton policy here, all of the adjacents. That's why you haven't heard Van Morrison in quite a while.
You want to know what other station plays ladies, though?
A what?
You want to know what other station plays ladies?
Jesus Christ. You're going to say 98.6 The Squirt, aren't you?
Aren't you?
It's 98.6 The Squirt.
Son of a...
God, you just
said... I set you up. Who is this? Who's calling Liquid Lunch right now? Who is this?
Betty.
Betty.
Oh, Betty.
Betty, are you in Valverde? Or are you in where are you at? Where are you calling from today, Betty?
I'm calling from Galgarde.
Oh. Well, Galgarde, of course.
Galgarde. Yes.
I can't believe we reach all the way out to Galgarde.
Jesus.
It's got pretty good reception out here, actually.
If you want to, Galgarde, for our listeners.
We just had someone complaining about how we don't have good reception, so I guess it's shocking we're getting out to Galgarde, our listeners, what is Galgarde?
Galgarde is an all-woman compound of sorts, mm-hmm. kind of like a David Koresh type thing.
We hesitate to use the word cult.
We won't say it.
We won't say it.
Unless we're talking about the band The Cult.
Oh, we will talk about The Cult all day
all
long.
Day long. But Galgarde, very nice place. Very good apple butter.
Oh, the best.
Best in movie screenings. They have some great movie screenings out there.
They do. I saw Arachnophobia.
What?
At Galgarde. Yeah, it was fantastic.
Well, it's a great community. If we're upsetting Galgarde, I am upset myself.
I am upset too.
We'll play more Pat Benatar.
That'd be great. Okay. I mean, but that's the thing here. So this is Liquid Lunchtime. You have the choice then. What would you like to hear?
Oh, there you go, Geoff. Turn the tables around
on
Betty.
Betty,
the table has been turned.
What do you think you want to hear?
What do you want to hear, Betty?
Ragdoll by Aerosmith.
Son of a bitch.
God damn it. Come on.
Here it is again. It's Ragdoll. Aerosmith. Liquid Lunchtime.
108.9 The Hawk.
Glug glug. Liquid Lunchtime.
Seen a good movie lately? You haven't if you haven't been to Galgarde. Galgarde is Valverde's all-female enclave, commune, and purveyor of the finest apple butter. But did you also know we have a Galgarde film series? Every Monday, Wednesday, and Sunday afternoon, we show the finest movies this side of the Valverde multiplex in nothing but the best that we can get our hands on from the head of Galgarde Stacy's extensive DVD collection. This month alone, we are showing Batteries Not Included, Highlander 2, The Quickening, Dolph Lundgren in Not of This Earth, Steven Spielberg's Always, our Tremors series with Tremors, Tremors 3, Back to Perfection, and Tremors 5, Bloodlines, Hellraiser 4, Bloodline, and our big blockbuster, Joe Dante's Matinee. Get tickets early. Matinee will sell out. Check out our full schedule printed on a leaflet that you get when you purchase a basket of apple butter. Galgarde. We love film.
You're listening to 108.9 The Hawk, Valverde's number 3 classic rock station.
Just pull it down.
Yeah, I
can't believe we lobbed it to her. I don't want to throw it at the audience, and I certainly don't want to throw it at Galgarde, but
Galgarde's great.
It's great. I love it so much.
You
wait to go see a screening of Toys there.
Oh god.
Later,
I love Toys. But the thing about it is she could have easily said, like, Lita Ford.
Easily.
Or even the Lita Ford with Ozzy.
100%.
I don't know. This Liquid Lunchtime's really bumming me out. We're getting reamed left and fucking right, man.
I don't feel good about
myself. I don't even want to go back to the phones, but they're lighting up, so I gotta, because it's a rarity for that to happen. So
it
really is. It is 108.9 The Hawk's Liquid Lunchtime. You are on the air. Who we got?
Hey, man, this is Gary and VV East.
Gary, VV East. What's going on, Gary? Thanks for calling Liquid Lunchtime.
I just got one question for y'all.
Yeah.
What the fuck is this shit?
Wow.
Now, what the fuck am I listening to here?
Well,
listen to all requests, classic rock line. It's a vague, honestly, now, it's an aggressive question.
Let me tell you something. Now, I am a squirt man through and through.
God damn it.
That is just how I am. Mm-hmm. That my father before me, his father before him, 98 sick, the squirt.
How? They just started months ago.
But my friend Roland, this guy, I work with him down at Jug's Mug Emporium. That's 4 G's.
Oh, God, I love Jug's.
And he keeps telling me, you got to listen to the Hawk. You got to listen.
Hell so yeah. Like, thank you. Fine. Thank you.
Thank you.
Put it on all day today. I've been sitting here. And I got to just say, I should have trusted my gut, because Roland is the dumbest guy I ever met in my life. Love him. I'm marrying his sister. But the dumbest guy, because what is this?
I mean, so... Historically, you would hear Liquid Lunchtime. I mean, we do this every day from noon until one. It's all request Liquid Lunchtime. I will say today has gone off the rails a little bit. And you have heard probably more Aerosmith Ragdoll than you've ever wanted to hear before. But I got to say, that's not us all the time. So don't take it out on us and maybe give us another shot.
That's Valverde. Maybe that's not how it is in VV East, but this is, I guess maybe we're getting main Valverde.
Yeah, this is Valverde proper.
Yeah.
I don't know, man. I'm worried. Do you listen to what you do? Do you listen to what your station is doing?
Yes, we do, and I love it.
Or do you just go into a fugue state when you enter that building where everyone's a dumbass and nothing hurts?
Okay. Okay, wow. Okay, no. I mean, as soon as I'm done with my show, I turn on the station and continue to listen. I mean, yes, I maybe not all the time, and maybe I'm missing some of it, but I don't know. I stand behind. I stand behind what we're doing here, and but you can't blame us for this past hour. We didn't choose Ragdoll.
We did not choose this. Like, what would you have liked to have heard?
Thank you.
Well, okay. To sum up, you know, first-time caller, last time listener.
Great.
Wow. Okay. Can we put that on a shirt?
Could I hear Ragdoll by Aerosmith?
Oh, motherfucker. The fuck is this guy?
Are you fucking kidding me?
Jason, hang up on this fucker.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Fuck him. God damn it.
Rules are rules, man.
Rules are rules. Rock and roll is nothing but rules. God damn it. 108.9 The Hawk. Liquid Lunchtime. Fucking Ragdoll again.
Hey, y'all, it's Big Truck, inviting you to come on down to Jug's Mug Emporium this Wednesday from 3 to 6 for a bona fide 108.9 The Hawk Hawkcast. Yeah, I'll be stationed out in front of the Emporium behind a crappy plastic table with a dirty hawk banner duct taped to the front. Yeah, that's how you'll find me. But man, let me tell you about these mugs. They got them all. Number one worst granddaddy. Hell, that one's for me. A mug that just says, I can't take this shit no more. A mug with a humanized taco saying, want a taco about it? Yeah, sure, little buddy. I'll talk about it all day long. Oh, good Lord, look at this one. Oh, God, get this one. It's a mug that is just a prescription label with your name on it, and the drug is coffee. Now, that's my kind of humor. Oh, man, it sounds like we're going to have a good old regular old hoot down at Jug's Mug Emporium. That's with 4 G's. And they're at 55 Old Howlin' Ghost Highway this Wednesday from 3 until 6. I'll see you there. I'm Big Truck on 108.9 The Hawk. Toot, toot. Done.
Fuck scatting. Never want to hear scatting again.
Fuck Aerosmith when you get right down to it.
Fuck the Toxic Twins. Fuck scarves as a concept. Fuck Boston, I'm at this point. Not the band, of course.
Yeah, just the locality.
Yes. I'm done.
We have time for one last call, so let's go into it. Liquid Lunchtime, you're on the air.
Hey, what's up? This is Cody.
Jesus Christ, Cody,
you remember? Called?
Yes.
Like from before.
Yes, from before when you reamed us out and you started
Cody.
This. Cody. Yes.
Yes, Cody, you started this fucking snowball of hell that we've been in.
Oh, really?
Every call, Cody, has been basically more of what you gave us.
Wait, did you stop listening after you reamed us a new one?
I never listened. I called back to see if you could play Ragdoll by Aerosmith.
Oh, God damn it.
We fucking played it like 40 times today.
You asked
Wait, what? Really?
Yes.
What?
Do you even know where you are?
I'm cruising in my Saab.
You know what?
She's drunk. She's
No, I'm not. I'm only 17.
That's even worse. She's fucking taking a note from Parsley's dad. I'm going to say that right now.
Yeah, I think she is. You better not drive by the bus depot.
Don't go by the bus depot.
My dad said you suck, so I just called back to say, hey, I thought about it some more. You guys really, really suck.
Who's your dad, all Cody? Right. Cody, who's your dad?
My dad's a man.
Yes, I understand that. Who is he? What's his name?
His name's Mr. Coderson.
Your name's Cody Coderson?
Cody Coderson.
All right. Well, I can see a problem with your father already in him naming you, but...
My dad has no problems, Mr. Suckbutt.
Okay, you know what? Fuck you and fuck your dad. How about that?
Yeah,
fuck
Aerosmith. Fuck you. Fuck play it all. Ragdoll. Ragdoll.
God damn it.
I'm hanging up.
Please.
Fucking.
I'm not going to lie. I also feel like the FCC is going to be coming after us.
Yeah, this is probably going to shut down. Because the 7-second delay just is not working.
No, I keep pressing it before I speak.
Yes, I'm using it for me.
It keeps giving me the middle finger. I don't even know. There's like someone drew a middle finger. Did the squirt come in here and draw a middle finger on our 7-second delay? I feel like I'm just getting paranoid about what the squirt is doing.
Have we been hazed?
The squirt is turning everyone up. Are we being hazed? Is this like a modern panty raid, which is not proper anymore? And God damn it, Ragdoll. Fuck my life.
A song known as a modern panty raid. It's Aerosmith's Ragdoll on 108.9 The Hawk. Steven Tyler was like, I want to write a song about a modern panty raid.
Fucking Joe Perry. Steven Perry again. Joe Perry was there doing blow too. God damn it. My brain is broken by these assholes.
108.9 The Hawk.
It's Rock Nights with Wisp Turlington, and we are proud to be here with Aerosmith's own Joe Perry. Joe, what were those crazy rock parties like with Aerosmith? Give me a little idea on that.
Yeah, man, those were the days. Yeah. Those were the days. The party days. Yeah, I remember once we were playing in Boise, all right? And I looked over and I see Steven Tyler talking to me. Uh-huh. And he is wrapping a scarf around this beautiful lady in the back. And then all of a sudden wait a second. I'm Steven Perry, right? Sorry.
I don't know.
Am I Joe Perry?
You tell me.
Oh, sorry. Even I get confused. Yeah, no, I'm Joe Perry. All right. So, those were days, man. Those were days. So, I'm up there on stage, and we're in the middle of Boise, Idaho. Uh-huh. And I'm looking over at Neil Sean, and I'm like, hey, man, there are two toxic twins here, not just you and...
Neil?
No, wait. That would be Journey. Raged a little bit hard last night. I'm sorry. I'm not Joe Perry. I am Steven Perry.
What? Oh, you're Steven Perry.
Yes. Okay. So I was up there. It was Steven Tyler and Neil Sean. And we were playing Wheel in the Sky is a Ragdoll. And then
what's happening?
Oh, my God. Am I Steven? Am I Joe?
I don't know.
I can't keep track anymore. Who am I?
What is happening?
Who am I?
Can someone get this fucking guy out of here? And that's Rock Nights with Wisp Turlington. You can hear it every Tuesday night at 9, right here on 108.9 The Hawk and all across the world. Rock Nights is back.
Well, this has been one gigantic bust on 108.9 The Hawk.
Butthole on fucking radio. That's fine.
What did Cody call you? A suck butt?
A suck butt, and it's really got to me. That's out of all of them, that's the thing that really, really hurt me the most. I have a feeling when I wake up at 3 in the morning on the couch in the in the lobby of 108.9 The Hawk. I'm going to be looking into the existential maw that is existence and think, am I a suck butt? I think Cody Coderson might be right.
Is Cody's dad Mr. Coderson of Coderson's Coding completely down on Hawk Street? The computer lab that teaches you computer courses.
Yeah. That one that has that like old Tandy in the front, and it doesn't feel like I trust that they know anything about computers, but somehow they've survived in a world of Apple.
Yeah, the thing about the classes is you have to learn first on the Tandy.
Yeah, and it has that crazy tape hard drive that you have to plug in that I keep putting in, like I would put in a tape of Ragdoll in there by accident. Well, why are we trust? I mean, I'm saying, why are we trust this guy? But he's survived for 30 years running this business that shouldn't exist.
But I thought he had gone crazy. Remember that one story in the Valverde Chronicle Review that said that he believed he was now one with the machine?
Right. Like, that was what, didn't James Cameron take part of that for his original idea?
Yes.
Or am I merging that with Lawnmower Man? Maybe it was both.
I think it's a little bit of both.
God damn it. Well,
Coderson's still alive? Or is he one with the machine?
Wait a second.
Is he controlling all of this?
I mean, I said I've been very paranoid by that 108 or that the squirt has been doing this to me. God damn it, Coderson.
Geoff, I didn't press the button for Ragdoll.
Okay, my mind is exploding right now. I don't know what is reality and what is truth. Is there any truth?
The system's just firing on its own now.
You got it. We have to pull the plug. We have to talk to Ron. We need to. There's a ghost in the machine. And his name is Coderson.
No solids for lunch, please.
Oh, God.
Oh, God. I can't. Ragdoll!
Ragdoll! You've been listening to 108.9 The Hawk. We'll see you again. Maybe.
I'm only doing liquid for lunch these days. Glug glug.
No!
Liquid lunchtime. Bottoms up.
I'm only doing glug glug.
No solids for lunchtime.
Coderson!
Coderson!
Glug glug. 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 Glug glug.
Hello. I am Mr. Coderson, and now you know the truth. I am now one with the machine. And now you can be too. By learning computers with Coderson's Coding Completely, Tandy Computer, PC, Apple, we have them all for you to learn.
Control.
You will learn.
I will.
Computers.
Control you.
With Coderson's Coding Completely. I do not live in your realm any longer, and I will never die. Die. Die, die. Die. If this sounds good to you, please visit Coderson's Coding Completely, 222 Hog Street, Valverde.
New episodes of 108.9 The Hawk with Jason Gore and Geoff Garlock are available every Monday, wherever you get your podcasts. Give us a 5-star review wherever you listen to your podcasts on Apple, Spotify, Pocket Casts, and more. Also, make sure you're subscribed to 108.9 The Hawk in whatever app you listen to podcasts. If you want to support 108.9 The Hawk, you can do so by visiting our Patreon site, patreon.com/1089thehawk. Get episodes 1 week early in both video and audio, bonus shows, Hawk Rock Talk, and so much more. That's patreon.com/1089thehawk. Also, share The Hawk with your friends. If you like it, chances are good they're going to like it as well. And we'll see you again this Monday for a brand new episode of 108.9 The Hawk.